let me explain about some of the most important file management commands. To start with, there is the ls command. Ls stands for list. It allows you to show which files are existing and which directories exist in the current location. Then there is mkdir, which is make directory. It allows you to create directories. And if you want to remove the directory, you will use rmdir to remove it. The next important command is cp, which stands for copy. It allows you to copy files from one location to another. Related to that, there is mv, which allows you to move files if you don't want to keep the file in the original location. And then the last is rm. RM is remove. It allows you to get rid of the files that you don't need anymore. Let me show you how this works on the console. So now that we have talked about these different commands, let me show you some. To start with, there's ls. Ls is listing directories and files. So if you do that in the root, you can see all files existing in the root directory. Oh, by the way, ls by default is showing all these colors. If you don't like the colors, use backslash ls. And that is because ls really is an alias that has been defined in the shell. And if you don't want this alias to work, but just want to have the plain command, ls will do that for you. Now let's go to my home directory using cd. We've seen that command before. Cd without any argument behind it will bring you always to the home directory of the current user. I want to show you ls-l. The long listing. This is showing information about the file type, the permissions, the owner, and the dates associated to the file as well. You might also like ls-a. You can see some additional files are shown now. Files that have a name that starts with a dot are not shown by default. You can consider them hidden files. And these hidden files like bash underscore logout and dot bash underscore profile and dot less hst, these are basically configuration files. So normal users have no business seeing them. And that is why they are hidden. Use dash a if you want to see them anyway. Another useful command, let me do that in the var log directory, is ls dash lrt. Dash lrt is sorting files based on their modification time. So the file that has been modified most recently is shown last in the list. And this can be a very convenient command if you are looking in a big directory containing many files and you just want to see files that have been modified recently. ls has many more options. Type ls-help to figure out about them. But I think with these examples we have seen some of the most useful. Now let's talk about mkdir. Mkdir creates a directory. So mkdir files, for example, creates a directory with the name files. Now you can use mkdir to create a complete path as well, but then you need mkdir-p, which will create the entire path. This is a path, for example. And ls will just show this because this has a subdirectory with the name is, which has a subdirectory as well, which has a subdirectory as well. Now you can use cp to copy files. It's a very important command. You will be doing that a lot as a Linux administrator. So cp etc hosts to dot, for example. Dot stands for the current directory. If you don't specify the current directory, then you'll get an error. Missing destination file operand after etc host. Using cp-help will explain why this is normal. And that is because cp needs a source as well as a destination. So cp etc hosts dot will do so much better. On some occasions, you might want to use cp to copy to a directory. If you want to copy to a directory, like cp etc pass wd to this, then it is wise to put a slash behind the directory name. Because, you know, you might make a mistake and you might want to try to copy a file to a directory that doesn't exist. If the directory doesn't exist and you don't put a slash behind it, then CP will create a file as a destination. And that might be confusing. And if you do put a slash behind it, then CP knows, oh, this is a directory and I should create the file within this directory. If you want to change the file name, you can do that as well. Just put the new file name in there. So this changed. We now have a file in the directory this with the name changed, which is exactly the same contents as the etc passwd. Now then we have the mv command. Mv is for move. So move changed to tmp, for example, and that will remove it from here and put it in the tmp directory, as you can see. You may also use mv to rename files. So move tmp changed to tmp renamed. The file changed doesn't exist anymore. Now we have a file with the name renamed. Then there is a command rmdir. Rmdir is, well, I don't think it's a very useful command because it does have some limitations. It can create directory only if it doesn't contain any more files. You'll see that, rmdir. Let's try dash dash help to see if it has useful options as well. You can use dash p. Dash p will work to contain a directory including the parent directories, but everything needs to be empty, which is why rmdir is not so very useful. You might be better off using rm. Rm command has an option dash r, which makes it recursive. Recursive means including subdirectories. So if we type rm dash r on this, then it is going to try to remove everything. ls dash l, and we can see that this doesn't exist anymore, including the contents of the directory. You should notice that if you do that as root, so let me show you the exact same thing as the root user as well. I'm using su dash to open a root shell. Here I go, I enter the root password and I'm creating a new path. This is a path like we've done before, oops, using dash p of course, and we copy all files that have a name starting A, B or C from etc to this is. We are getting some error messages on directory that are omitted, that doesn't really matter. Let's use rm-r on this, and then you can see that it's asking confirmation, descent into directory, yes. Descent into directory, yes, 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 and it's asking confirmation for everything we want to do. That is because I'm doing it as root now. And if you are doing it as root, then you may get unexpected results and you might accidentally wipe your entire system. So if you really are sure of what you are doing as root, type rm-rf. Just want to show you one more thing, and that is a bash shell feature that is working here. So the feature is alias. And an alias is like a command that has been created for a specific shell environment. Here we can see the aliases that apply to the root user. And one of them is rm, which in fact executes rm-i. Dash I for interactive. If we type alias as a normal user, you can see that there is no alias for RM. So as a root, it will by default become interactive. As a normal user, it won't be interactive, which is why normal users can remove entire directory trees without using the option dash F, and the root user must use dash F as a protection for things going wrong. And these are the essential file management tasks.